Hello, my name is Peter Jerry, and I am making this video dedicated to the 40th birthday of Pastor Tade Ayodele. I have known Pastor Tade Ayodele for almost a year now, and three things have been noticed in his life. I've discovered that he pays so much attention to the matter of family, ministry, and business. He desires that everybody has a very wonderful family and you do well in your business. Now, I'm going to be focusing my broadcast on the matter of ministry, specifically to the issue of prayer, the prayer life of a minister. In recent times, it's been discovered that many platforms, many ministries, churches, and even gatherings of the body of Christ have paid so much attention to the matter of prayer more than years before. I wouldn't know why, but I believe strongly that the Lord has poured a special anointing and a revival in the place of prayer. And I tell you, when the prayer life of a person is being activated, so many possibilities are very, very key in coming in. All right. As a young minister of the gospel, I have discovered that many of my fellow brethren do not take the matter of prayer to heart. I have come to realize that fellow young ministers, the first thing that comes to mind when they receive the call is visibility. Now, in the few years I have spent in ministry, I have discovered that prayer has done more for me than my energy. Whatever you power with prayer lasts longer than what you power with your skills. The Bible says in the book of Acts of Apostles chapter 6 and verse 4 that in the time when there was a crisis in the first church, the first thing they did was not to call a committee meeting. The first thing they did was to pray. The Bible said, verse 4 actually, the apostles stood up and told them and said, "We will commit ourselves to prayer and the ministry of the word." And the law of first mention says that when something is mentioned first, then it means that it is a priority. Then it means that prayer is actually a priority in the ministry. Paul, talking to the Colossian church, he said that we always remember you in our prayers. It means that prayer as the pathway for the kingdom manifestation of a minister cannot be overemphasized. Listen to me, brethren. If you will take prayer very serious, then your ministry will be impactful. Do you want to experience a ministry that lasts and persists and you are able to do much more than the world can expect you to do? Then go into prayers. The first thing to do is not to seek for branding. The first thing is not to seek for a logo for your ministry. The first thing is not even CAC registration, as much as that is very important. But I tell you the truth, brethren, prayer is very key. It is in the place of prayer you receive strategic instructions from the Lord. It is in the place of prayer that you receive strategy. You remember, the scripture says concerning the man called David. It said that there was a time the Philistines came and they wanted to meet him to fight the Israelites in a valley, the valley of Rephaim. And he inquired of the Lord whether we like it or not, whether it was mentioned or not. That was prayer. And then he inquired of the Lord the first time. The Lord said, "Go up, and I have given these people into your hands." The second time, few verses downward in the same chapter, David asked the Lord again. Now, what comes to my mind is, for every step you take, even if it is the same matter that is coming to you, you always need a new strategy from the Lord. And you cannot receive strategies from executive councils. You only receive strategy from the one who sent you. If you will do well in ministry, if you will have a ministry that is sustained, if you will have a ministry that is impactful, then you must take prayer serious. Many times we unconsciously forget, and seriously now, I want to excuse you, but this excusing is just for the main time. I want to excuse you that as humans, we forget that the only answer to every imperfection of our life is prayer. Jesus said that men ought to always pray and not to faint. Listen to me. And that is in the book of Luke chapter 18. He taught them how to pray. When the disciples were coming to ask the Lord for anything, he didn't teach them how to preach. Now, it's so funny that as much as evangelism is important, he didn't teach them how to evangelize, but he taught them to pray. So the matter of prayer is a matter that we must take to heart if we will have an impactful ministry. If we will have a family that will come together. There's this saying that says, a family that prays together stays together. So if you as a minister of God will not take prayer serious, then don't expect that the congregation that follows you will take prayer serious. Don't expect that people in your congregation will pray. If the pastor will not pray, then the members will not pray. If the apostle will not pray, then the members will not pray. If as a prophet you do not pray, the members who follow you, who listen to you, will not pray. Many times we take the matter of prayer as though it is secondary. But I tell you, prayer is primary. So all the things you do in life, forgetting the fact that prayer is even important, do you know that just as oxygen is important to our biological life, so also is prayer important to our spiritual life? You pray without ceasing. That's what the Bible says. And there's this song that says, permit me to sing this song. Prayer is the key. Prayer is the key. Prayer is the master key. Now, if it says prayer is the master key, it means that for you to call something or a key the master key, it means it opens all doors. So, are you experiencing closed doors in your ministry? Pray. Are you experiencing slowness in the way your ministry is impacting lives? Please pray. Are you experiencing delay in your marriage? Please pray. Are you experiencing crisis in your relationship? Please pray. Nothing can overcome a man who prays. My friend, Pastor Jeffrey Richard, he said something, and I quote, he said, a man who can pray is not disadvantaged. And I hold on to that statement so much. It means that even if there's anything happening to your life, once you are able to pray, you are able to succeed. Once you are able to pray, you have an advantage. And I want to repeat something that Pastor Tade said in the month of September. Very funny. We were taking the series of prayer. And one thing he kept saying is that if you don't pray, then you are proud. Do you want to experience an open heavens? Because the Bible said that God looks at a proud man from afar. If you want to experience an open heaven, that God will be experienced in your ministry, men will be able to encounter God easily in your ministry, then please pray. I want to encourage you above all, pray. Let prayer be what you will feed on. Let prayer be the essence of your life. And I pray for you in the name of Jesus that the spirit of revival to pray will come upon you in the name of Jesus. And I want to use this medium to once again celebrate Pastor Tade on his 40th birthday. Pastor Tade, I want you to know that I love you. And there's definitely nothing you can do about it. Thank you for being a pastor to me. Thank you for feeding me. Thank you for being a shepherd. I want to appreciate God in your life and the life of your wife and your family. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you for us in Jesus' name. Thank you very much. Bye.